Good morning, good morning. So glad you could join us. Here we are at the communion table again, excited about being here. And I'll just read a few scriptures, all right? It says Matthew 26:26, while they were eating, Jesus took the bread, and after blessing, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is for you." And when he had taken a cup, he'd given thanks, he gave it to them saying, "Drink from it, all of you, for this is the blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins." So we have the bread, which is his body, the wine, which is his blood. And other places Jesus speaks, he said, "He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life. For my flesh is true food and my blood is true drink. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me." Wild statements, isn't it? He says another place, he says, "I'm the living bread that came down from heaven." Isn't that amazing? So let's take some moments this morning, just remember what he's done for us. Jesus became our sin, he became our shame, he became our sickness. And the Bible says even while we're yet sinners, even while we're yet his enemies, he died for us. It's great news, isn't it? Come on. So he came to bring us real life. Do you know that? A whole new life, abundant life, a life overflowing. And he brought us purpose, he brought us hope, he brought us love. And it's not like the world's love, but he brought us God's love. It's so great. And a love that God opened our hearts. When we do this, when we're at the communion table, I believe all the more our hearts are opened and he gives us his love to know and experience. And so I just want to encourage you today as we're doing this, I know we're doing this weekly, we just don't want to do it as a religious exercise, but this is really something that we come with an expectation. Like God, we're expecting that you tell us to come boldly to your throne of grace to find help in time of need. So I just encourage you to come today as you partake of communion, do this in faith. He wants to meet us here today. And I just want to encourage you, no matter where you're at in your life, maybe you've dealt with a continual sin or sickness or addiction, or you feel like you're in a place of fear or worry or strife, man, I just know at this communion table, you can be changed. Amen. The body and the blood of Jesus covers every area of our existence. And I just want to encourage you, if you're in a place of weakness, he'll strengthen you today. If you're in a place where you're overwhelmed with sickness, he wants to release healing to you today. There's been testimony after testimony of people healed when they really meet the Lord in communion. So maybe you're stressed or overwhelmed or worn out or thirsty, and I just encourage you to receive his presence, his refreshing at this time of communion. Amen. So we want to come here. We want to come in reverence. We want to come with humility and honesty. And the Bible talks about just taking every time we come together in communion, taking these simple elements that we examine our own hearts. And Lord, examine my life. Save, show me if there's anything in my life that's unclean or contrary to you. And God, we just want to be washed and cleansed as we do this. Amen. So it's a great time. Every time I take communion, I love to take that time and do inventory. And I always say, God, I just want to commit my life to you as I do this today, or recommit my life to you. If I've done it over and over, it's a good thing today to do that, all right? He's just given so much for us. So yeah, just take the bread. It says, you know, his body was given for us. The night that he was betrayed, he took the bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it. And he said, "Eat this bread. This is my body, which is broken for you." So we do this together. If you're with me, take an element and we'll just pray. Amen. So we take the bread and we receive Jesus, your body, the body of Christ. We receive it in your name. Amen. In the same way, he took the cup. And I just love, he took the cup of the new covenant, which is given and poured out for. I love when it says he's poured out for the remission of our sins. That means not just a covering, that means a complete removing of all that's unclean. So let's take this together. Lord Jesus, we thank you for your blood. We thank you that it was poured out for our lives. Receive your life today, this abundant, overflowing life. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. Well, that's good. Well, have a great day. Thanks for joining us.